Alhan, you're wrong because you're saying you can retrieve the information. If that was the case and you could really retrieve the information, we would all have the same information and we would all vote for the same people. You don't know nothing either, bro.
Welcome back to the greatest show on planet Earth, people. How are you?
Disappointed that YouTube make things very difficult to walk in the building.
But you know what?
Go on.
I want to hear you vent about it because I completely agree with you.
But
you need more than like a 10K or 100K or something subscribers. So a lot of the people watching this will never actually get to experience this problem. So we are just venting. Vent to me. Talk to me.
Oh, to an empty room to say, I don't want to do it no more.
No, talk to me.
But the service is provided for the people.
Mm. It's basically first world problems.
Yeah, I don't want to
say it. That's exactly what it is.
Fully understand where you're coming from.
Tiny Boost, great episode.
Fucking don't sick.
You know what? I think my editor, she's starting to get a bit bored.
I heard her say this to you, but I think you're getting complacent as well. So I think you should look closer to home before you talk about
Maya. Fix your yard before you fix abroad.
Dance a yard before you dance abroad.
However,
go on.
I'm complacent, but things still happen. Like, but I think Maya, it's like...
No, I'm not going to let you get on Maya. You rely on the fact
that you're talented. I'm not getting on Maya. No, I'm not saying about talented. I'm just saying, like, we might be complacent and lazy when it comes to organising things, but it's like, we're here.
But then that has a ripple effect on everyone else. So if we were a little bit more organised, we can go Maya, but if Maya's a bit disorganised due to our being... dance a yard before you dance abroad. Yes,
I like how you said our, but it's all me. Because you actually on top of stuff.
Not anymore, boy.
I will say this though, because Gasworks episodes used to be like 25, 30 minutes, but now they're just 45 minutes. I think Maya just like...
Or
we're getting funnier.
I mean, I doubt I am.
So it's a compliment.
I think you're getting... You're always funny anyway. Maybe we should stop being complacent. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, so we should work harder.
We should work harder.
But we have to remember...
One thing.
Gasworks is on a channel that is owned primarily by...
The white man.
Okay, so maybe this is actually our plan.
Yeah.
That we become complacent, but really...
We're trying to bust it up.
Right.
Do our own thing. Right. And then we take Maya, Camilla, I hear you,
right.
Taz.
Right. People, welcome back. This is Gasworks. I'm just doing it again, innit? You know what? We can just do... I normally like to drag out the intro because sometimes we have a boring guest. For example, Swarms or... Okay, fine. Mira May.
No, I'm not having that.
Okay, fine.
Not that I was having Swarms as well. I wasn't having...
No. Should we go back to...
I've said enough.
Yeah, you have said enough. Fuck, man. It was easier on Copper 90, innit?
No, I think that was almost like abuse, you know?
Because that you had to pretend to like about... I remember
I had to pretend to like everyone.
But you said you didn't like football. Do you remember that time? That was sick, man. Hey, people, man, I can't lie. This is a guest that I've wanted on for time. I'm a massive fan. There's bare stories of me, like, 13, climbing into his, like, back windows and just...
His house? I haven't read that. You have to climb to his house sometimes.
You get me?
But he's actually the reason we got on radio for the first time. On One Extra. He was, like, he just randomly said, I like you lot. And I was like, oh, do you reckon you can get us on radio? And within seconds, we featured on One Extra.
I don't know if you can hear us, but... He's in the room, but he's just like a lovely person.
Love him. I always feel like I'm bothering him.
Can I sit there for this episode?
Of course you can. But
Actually, no. Stay there. Because it look too eager, man.
Oh, you don't want to look too eager.
Yeah,
I'll do sometimes is I'll branch backwards like I'm gonna laugh, and then you lean.
Yes, I hear you.
Alright, cool. Cinema.
Okay. You say you're gonna branch backwards?
Go on. What's the joke?
You're a branch. My guy.
Tremendous.
My guy. Camilla's all sending me WhatsApp saying we should move on.
Oh, is it?
Oh, what's this girl's problem?
She didn't send it to me, but I rate that.
Yeah, because I'm more approachable.
Okay.
Yeah, you would just start arguing.
Possibly.
Yeah, and then say, I'm on your side, half an hour later.
Oh, you're just making it back to me and you again?
Yeah.
You little emotional bitch.
No, I'm not emotional. I do love you.
I do love you. I love you too. Yeah. Kind of. Bro, I hate you, Vision Specs.
Where?
So, just can you call Jamie in, please?
I mean, I'm enjoying this.
Jamie!
Hey, Jamie, welcome, man.
What's going on, man? What's happening?
The greatest. How are you, bro?
I'm good, man. What's happening?
So, Frisco was our first episode of Gasworks ever.
Yeah.
Obviously, your comrade and your close colleague. Yeah. But you were the first person to ever really tweet it and show us love as well.
Okay.
So, you've been there from the start.
Thank you very much. Thank you, man.
So, why has it taken you all 90 episodes to come on?
I don't do nothing, man. No, why has it taken you 90 episodes to ask me to come on?
It's true. That is very true. Obviously, Grime MC is out now, so...
Yeah. No, but you haven't asked me to come on before.
Jamie's talking the truth. I can show you the fixed conversation where I texted him. Yeah. But I was just really like scared of asking.
The L's out. But there's a question we'd like to ask all our special guests, Jamie.
Yeah.
Are you a bowl cap?
No. Sorry, man. I'm married, obviously, so.
I've got a child, and I've got parents,
and she's got parents, so I won't speak on our sexual relations. Of course. But obviously, growing up, this is a good thing as well, I want to speak about this. Growing up, yeah, in North London in what, the 90s, the 2000s? Wait, you didn't even ask me the question.
I did.
Did you ask a question?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
It spun you that much.
Yeah, but in my head, I'm thinking you didn't even ask me. But yeah, calling someone a bocat was a diss.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I think it's from Jamaican culture.
That's exactly why we asked the question.
I know, but I want to help you with this one because I think you are not going to make it not a diss. Mm. Just same way as all of our parents have sexual relations, but you would never call your mum a headers.
Yeah.
I think you know what I mean? No, you wouldn't.
He just said his mum hasn't got a back off a couple of episodes.
No, stop. Let's not make the disrespect on this episode. Let's not make it. Right. No, but for real, like, or you wouldn't call your brethren's girl a headers.
Nah.
You know what I mean? If she gives your brethren heads, that's their business, yeah?
But you know what? You know what? You're old and you've had time to wisen. You're married. You've got a lovely wife, kids, everything. But when you're younger, it's different, I think.
No, I'm not even old. But listen, boom.
Older.
Yeah, I'm older. But listen to this one, though. I got younger friends that are fine with it. You know what I'm saying? Mm. They're fine with it. Like, they tell me that I missed out growing up. Like, you missed out. You know what I'm saying? They're fine with it. But they wouldn't call themselves a bocat. I think calling it that.
The term bocat is
Yeah, it's a diss.
Yeah.
That's a diss. And I don't think that's ever going to change. I think
it's becoming less of a diss, though.
Do you reckon?
Yeah.
I think it's the environment as well. The environment that we provide, we're not trying to insult you. You're fully aware of that. So if you interpret it like that, it kind of says more about you than it says about us, because I'm fully aware it's a diss, but the way in which he says it, I'm not offended. Like, I wouldn't be offended. Whereas when someone says it with that malice, like you're a bocat to like make an embarrassment of you, I'm like, yeah, I'm not really a part of that.
Yeah, yeah.
But at the same time, I hear where you're coming from.
Yeah. So, simple answer, no.
No, nah, sorry, man.
Actually, no, we don't care for that one.
Why?
We don't
care for that one. Why? But I'm supporting it though.
Okay, you're supporting it.
I think too late for me, bro. I'm saying people that are growing up right now, don't be afraid of that in the bedroom, but don't be a bocat. Don't be the guy that just goes out and is just a bocat, bruv. You'll get what's it called? When you get that ulcer at the side of your mouth and that. Herpes, but in your mouth. What's it called? A coleslaw?
Yeah.
You end up with them guys with the coleslaw lips and all that stuff there.
I can't lie, man. I love coleslaw. Especially
stop, man. Be serious. You're being this is sexual education. This is sexual education.
Well, it is
a lot of young people watch your show. Boom. Yeah, girls, don't be a uckers. Don't be a shiners. Don't be a headers. Man, don't be a bocat, but just be free in the bedroom with your partner and have fun, enjoy yourselves, but stay protected, be careful, and you know what I'm saying? Don't get, what's it called?
Boys. Closer.
Responsible thing.
Boys, keep your head down.
What camera do you look at, man?
Any camera you want.
All right, cool. I'm looking at that one all the time. I got you gifts, though.
I see that. Yeah? Thank you very much.
What?
I got you both umbrellas.
It is one. I can have it.
Yeah, you can. You asked for it too early, though.
It's better.
That's cold.
And I got you both,
it's better than the Rolls Royce ones, man. Thank you very much.
Yeah, man, I thought I'd bring gifts. I was meant to bring you some vegan sweets, some marshmallows, some sweets and that, but
I was thinking, I don't know if any of these snacks are vegan.
No, I don't think M&M's are.
What about these crisps?
Ready?
Sensations?
Normal ones are.
Oh, shit in a bag and punch it. This is cold.
This is wonderful, man. Thank you very much.
Thank you, man. So
the whole magazine, behind the scenes.
Yes.
I'm most excited for the umbrella because what's a Dex umbrella, 35 bags. This is better than a Rolls Royce.
No, but UK, we need to have umbrellas, man. We live in the UK. That's something that no one's done. We live in the UK, it rains all the time. We should have umbrellas, we should have good umbrellas. So I thought, you know what, I'll try.
Thank you, Jamie. Out.
So Alhan.
That new book smell, this is buff.
What school did you go to?
Ooh. What, primary or secondary?
Secondary.
I can't really disclose that information. Why are you asking?
No, it's questions, man.
What, you're controlling the interview?
Nah, it's Gio's interview.
Yeah, no. I don't disclose secondary school still.
All right, boom. Poet, you was on Channel U before me. Mm-hmm. You inspired me.
What?
You inspired me, man. I see you on TV and I thought, right, a man can do this. Boom.
Ross.
Do you write bars daily or do you only write when you have to, like when you're in a studio or when you got a tune? Because obviously you had sick bars, sick flow. I know that you wrote those bars. That's not something someone would have written for you. So it's in you to write bars and to flow on music. How do you live your daily life without having to do that every day?
Yeah,
or do you do you only write when you're in? Because I hear you on tunes as well.
Oh, no.
I haven't. Ask questions if you want. These are the things I thought I'd ask you.
I only write when I'm inspired. So if I hear something sick, then I'm like, oh my God. And then I'll just literally think of something to write off the back of getting energy from something else. But I couldn't just be like not listening to music or not watching something, or it's literally down to inspiration. And it could be anything. I could watch, I don't know, something from Outhand and he could say something wordplay wise and I'm like, oh, that's sick. Imagine that was, and then I'll say something, or Vooj or even Zoo or yourself, or not everyone, some people
I'd rather not watch them. But it's just down to like watching content. Keep it to yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's down to what.
Swarms.
No, Swarms actually could inspire me 100%.
I was going to say, why are you lot on Swarms as well?
No, we love him. We love him. We love him. We're boosting his popularity. He's got more figures. You're welcome.
Yeah, man, how you look big, man. You heard the album?
You know what? I bought the vinyl and I got a copy of the CD.
I want the vinyl.
I don't have any ways of listening to it.
Yeah.
My turntable, the thing broke.
Needle.
Not the needle. The magnetic, the, what do you call it, man? The belt.
Belt drive.
Belt drive is broken. Belt drive. So.
I've heard it though. I came to.
Yeah, yeah, I saw it. I was in Birmingham.
That was
yeah.
Okay, sick. Yeah. That was cool.
That wasn't all
nine
the songs.
Nine songs, yeah, it was nine songs.
I can't lie, the videos were
ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
Thank
man.
You, man.
Ridiculous.
What was the one that was it? You in space?
You know.
Yeah, it reminded me of Over Me.
Is this an idea you've always had?
What?
To release a project like this?
No, I don't want to release it.
Just spontaneously came to you to do this?
No, it's taken a year. It's taken 3 years. I made You Watch Me. I made that with Essex in 2016.
This is
because you know what it is. I watched the interview of you time ago in what's that city festival called again? Wireless, I think it was Wireless or somewhere else. But you were sitting down on the grass and you were speaking about finding a new way of distributing music and your frustration with the way it is today. That's why I asked if it been something that you've had in your mind for a long period of time.
The frustration with me, not frustration, but the thought that wow, all us musicians are just like employees. We're just doing something for some big streaming thing, some big companies. That's all we do. Like, we make music, we get inspired, whether you get inspired from loss of life, somebody passes away and you write a real heartfelt song, whether you get inspired from whatever, something happens in your life and you're like, oh, this song is amazing. You go out club and you think, oh, I need to make a song like this, whatever it is, whether you're acoustic, digital, rapper, whatever you are, you all make music. And then you put it in this place and everyone has to go to listen to it. And that's what frustrated me. I thought, rah, that's not what I want to do. I make videos and put them out and they just go nowhere. Like, people know the lyrics. Like, if I go on stage and go, if you don't know my voice by now, then rude boy, check out the face. People start singing along. But they won't know what song it is. They just heard it. Whether they've heard it, they've seen me in an Iron Man suit and whatever, or they've heard someone remix the a cappella because I put the a cappella out, whatever. But that song's not on an album. It's nowhere.
That's cold.
That's what it was anyway. I didn't know what to do with my music. I had no idea what to do with my music. So then I just didn't do nothing. I just kept it, played it myself, showed my friends. But I thought, you know what? I've done bare videos. I wanted to show videos on the street with a projector. That's what I wanted to do. And then Felix said, oh, ask Darcy from Everyman. I spoke to Darcy, boom, Everyman tour. Did the Everyman tour at the beginning of the year. Then I had nothing else to do. No idea.
Number one.
Nothing.
The last physical I ever saw was Konnichiwa.
Yeah.
That was on vinyl and on CDs.
People did, but they don't push it as much.
Yeah.
Like Skepta's last album, Ignorance is Bliss, the vinyl is heat sensitive.
Yeah.
I didn't even know. I bought it, put my hand on it, and it's my handprint stays there, like heat sensitive, and it disappears slowly. Like, I would have pushed that like mad, like, yo, it's collective. It's like something you can have, like, you actually holding it, reading it, take the sleeves out, read it. I don't know, man. I just think we're all artists, bro. And we shouldn't put all of our art in the same place. We should at some point, you know what I'm saying?
That's the thing, like, you are one of the biggest gram artists in this country, in the world. So the thing about this one is the only way to listen to Gram MC is to go and actually into the shop and buy the physicals.
Now you can bootleg it.
Yeah, you can bootleg it. I'm sure there's downloads online, but like predominantly your fans, they obviously are gonna wanna support you and stuff.
This isn't all done on purpose, by the
way. I'm sure you didn't, yeah.
But it's good.
The videos are bad boy.
Exactly. I don't know what to do with the videos still.
No, but didn't you have a site? I saw you had a site where sometimes you used to direct traffic.
Webbutton.com.
I used to direct traffic to watch.
I was on Vimeo as well.
I used to put my videos.
I've never seen a music video on Vimeo, boy.
That's what I did before my last project with Integrity. I put all the videos on Vimeo.
Can't you do something?
And then put them so you can't link them to any other website.
No views.
No view counter. No nothing. Not even a rewind button. Just play. No volume either. So everyone's like, the volume's not on, but they have to go to Vimeo, turn the volume up on there, and then it'll go up on my site as well. But basically, it was just so you can watch it like a cinema experience in a way.
So you done vinyl, you done the CDs. Why wouldn't you have done DVD?
Because I don't own a DVD player. I'm not a film buff. You know what I mean? I'm a music lover. So I've got a turntable, I've got a CD player, I've got a CD drive for my Mac. I love music, you know what I'm saying? And if I find an old tape that says Heat FM, da da da, I'll go out and buy a cassette player so I can play it. Like, I actually like music, you know what I'm saying? It's been for years. But hey, anyway, I actually like music, innit? So I didn't release the CD for people to go out and buy the CD and then go and buy a CD player and say, oh, I've got to listen. I released the CD and vinyl because everyone asked me to. They said, release it at least physically. So I done it. So everyone is upset. Why didn't he release it streaming? He would have been number one. He would have. I didn't release it to be number one. I didn't release it for you either. You know what I mean? I released it for everyone. I released this for everyone that's got it and is happy. That's it. So everyone complaining, anyone saying, oh, he should have done this. Oh, he should have done that. Oh, why has he done this? Like, doesn't he know, like, no one's got a CD player? People that haven't got a CD player, I didn't make it for you. You know what I'm saying? I made it for people that actually care and actually love music so much that they've got their music collection and they've got a way to listen to it. So I'm adding to it. That's what I wanted to do.
Like society now, that's everyone wants quick, easy, instant, what, midnight is out, call on the phone.
Not everyone.
No, not everyone, no, but majority of people, like that. That's just the way everything is now, quick.
But Amazon, we don't Prime do the majority, now. That's the thing.
Like, when you go on Amazon, yeah, and you see it's going to be delivered tomorrow, even that sometimes rubs you up the wrong way. Like, what, tomorrow? I want it now. Like, everything's instant, like, bang, bang, bang. But this, again, it's an experience that you have to leave your house, go with your friends, queue up.
I've been making music for time. You know what I mean? What should I be doing now? Should I, like, I could make 8 tracks a day. I said this on the phone on the way here. I could make 8 tracks a day, produce the beat, write the bars, think of the melody, think of the harmony, spit it, make sure it's not same as something else I've done, give it to the MSM to mix and master quickly, and I go on to the next one and keep doing that. And like, what should I do? Should I just keep making 8 tracks a day forever? Like, what is music? You know what I mean? To me, like, music to me is something that I actually live with. I love music, bruv. I love music so much. I've got headphones in my pocket right here. I've got headphones in my bag over there. I roll with a Bluetooth speaker sometimes. Like, I love music, bruv. So I make music for me, people like me that love music. You know what I'm saying? So it's not my fault that the majority and the public and blah, blah, blah have gotten to it now and they want it. Like, they want it instantly, just like they want the rest of their instant stuff. I'm not catering for you.
Yeah.
Like, if you like it, cool.
That's fine. What I'm saying. It's sick.
You know what I'm saying? Just like a restaurant. If there was a restaurant like that had like a few tables and whatever, but there's the chef in there that he makes, boom, food, like whatever, whatever. No, everyone can't just fit in there. Oh, you got to make your restaurant bigger and bigger. You got a franchise, you have to. No, you don't have to, bro. This is my little restaurant. This is what I do. You know what I'm saying? If you get a seat, come in and eat, whatever, whatever, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Otherwise, go and get the Reboard. Download the bootleg. Go to the Reboard and go and eat there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't care about nothing other than making the music and hearing it back and vibing. That is it. Where it charts. Oh, it charted here, it charted there. Bro, if Stormzy, Ed Sheeran, flipping Adele, everyone released the week you released, you're finished. You're not charting nowhere, bro. So the chart just means you got a nice strategic plan and your distributor says, yeah, look, this week's clear and puts you out here, and then maybe flipping someone at Apple Music or Spotify might place you on these playlists to get you more plays and blah, you know what I mean? And yeah, your chart, it looks good. That's if you're playing that game. I'm not playing that game, bro.
So you've obviously taken a year off Twitter, yeah? What is it, like, do you not like numbers? Well, you've never had Instagram. All the pictures you've ever uploaded are on Flickr. What is it with your numbers? They're rubbing you up the wrong way?
Nah, man, nothing rubs me. Sometimes I just sit down and think. That is the answer, bruv. So I sat down and I thought about it. Instagram came out. The day it came out, I saw Instagram. I looked at it. It said, oh, upload pictures to here. And I thought, rah, I'm using Twitter and they've got TwitPic and I upload pictures to there. So why should I get Instagram?
The one, man.
Why should I get Instagram? I don't know what to get. It's just another app. So say somebody makes another one that they did, Snapchat. And then say someone makes another one called Grayslate. And someone makes another one called Screen. Someone makes another one called Orange Can. And it's all these sites. Do I just sign up to every site? Like, yeah, sign up. I'm on all them. I'd be on Orange Can, Green Screen, Yellow Screen. Like, what the hell? Like, what am I doing, bruv? Like,
it's exhausting, you know?
This is crazy.
It's absolutely exhausting. When I was on Snapchat, I was like,
There are certain ones that...
If it does something different,
yeah,
I'm on it, bruv. If there was ever a social network where it was like voice notes, it was just voice notes to everyone, pinging voice notes back and forth, that was it. I'll probably get that and say, everyone, let's get on there. Boom, boom, boom. It's like a walkie-talkie app nearly, basically. So I'll get that. But I'm not going to go and get Instagram where I've got something that does exactly the same thing. And then as it goes on, Facebook buys it. It turns into some next popularity contest. It's just weird.
I miss MSN. You can see what people were listening to. All songs that I sent it to sick, me, man. And they sent it to you, like, that song's lit, then you're listening to it.
Do you remember the emoticons? Like, there was that woman laughing.
What were they called again?
Nudge and shit.
Nudge was called.
Nudge. Man, what the?
No.
They were emoticons.
Good days, man.
But yeah, numbers, I ain't got a problem with numbers, bro. It's just, I think it's not doing any good. And as time goes on, I look at it and I think, right, this is getting mad weird. Like, I'm with everyone, but chilling. And then someone will go,
oh my God, I hate it.
No, and they'll speak. So we're chilling, everyone's chilling, whatever. And someone will go,
yeah.
Yes, mad. It's mad in here, little AJ. And I'll do that and I'll put it down. And I want to look at them. I want to look at them and be like,
I want to know how to say it like that.
What are we doing? Like, what's going on?
How do I say it like that?
I don't do nothing. Angry. Do you know what I do?
It's like, what are you doing? Don't
fool me. I make a note of it in my head. I remember this. They're not around no more.
Big up Terminator.
I hate that. I even hate this one. Like, when it's someone I haven't seen or I don't know that well, and they just run up to me from somewhere and they're filming me. God forgive me for doing this. The other day it happened. I took the person's phone and dashed it across the street.
It's happened a couple of times still.
I just literally took it out of their hand and threw it across the street.
Well, I'm not going to incriminate no one, but one time I was walking through Wireless Jardy Festival and someone got quickest way to the stage is to walk through the crowd instead of walking around. Oh yeah, I know I talk too fast, by the way. I watch myself on podcasts and stuff. I'm going to slow down from now on.
Can put it on zero.
Do your thing, man. There's no rules.
Yeah, it was walking through the festival. Specs. Quickest way was to go through the crowd and was walking through all of us.
It sounds
BBK.
Weird like this.
Yeah. Ah. And then somebody came
out. Go back to JME, man.
Somebody, hey, listen to me, man.
I'm trying,
somebody came out and grabbed one of us and went, oh my God,
took the phone on stage, spitting with the phone, gave it back to security after and said, yeah, lost phone. Took it. Just took it. You know what I'm saying?
I don't blame you, fam.
I remember there was a time when you would say, someone approached you on the street to take a photo of you, show me what work you, show me, have you bought my album? Yeah. Have you done something?
I haven't bought it. Just, do you rep me, man? Do you care about me, really? Exactly. Or are you taking a picture to get...
The one that pisses me off, or something, or the House of Parliament.
Are you that guy on YouTube? Yeah. Oh, let me grab a picture. But why?
One of my questions.
You don't know who I am.
Alhan, you're a very recognisable character. As your popularity level increases weekly, how are you coping with being recognised out in public?
I love it. I like it a lot, man.
Oh, does he love it?
To me, like I was saying earlier, it's like I care about tangible things. Comments, likes, whatever, it's all, I love it, it's appreciative. You can see your followers go up every day.
But the reason why as well is because, he gave them a screening and I saw someone say, ah, oh, can't believe it. I'm more gassed for seeing Alhan than JME. in my head, I thought, what? And I thought, wait a minute. No, that's true. That's true.
Okay,
it's true. It's true, though. It's true because Alhan's bait. He's bait. He's bait, innit? Like, it's Alhan. But you don't see him. Like, I don't see him. When I see him, it's like, right, Alhan. Like, went, the other day, he came past the shop I was in. I was like, right, what's going on? And I don't even see this guy. How are you coping?
I love it, man. I love it. It's like, sometimes it's a lot. Like, there was one time, we went out for Pakistani food with my mum, like, family. I'm getting in a car now and someone's done exactly like flash on. Alhan, we saying you're out here on the streets. So like, first of all, I'm parked up and I was like, bro, don't, like, the family's in the car. Like, if you want to take a picture, just come up to me, ask, like, normally. Anyway, yeah. So on his phone, it was on Snapchat, he'd done it. So I've asked him to stop doing it. He's saved the video. You know, you have the option to save to camera roll.
I don't know these things, man. People get me with this.
You can save to camera roll, just like whatever. I was like, bro, why have you saved that? I just told you to stop. I was like, why are you doing that? Anyway, yeah. I was like, look, we can take the picture, just delete that. So he went in his camera roll, he deleted the thing. Because he's got my family in it, man.
Recently deleted.
Yeah, recently deleted as well. I was like, cool. We posed. He's giving his version. I just dipped. I left him there, man.
What?
I left him.
You didn't take the picture?
He violated.
Oh, wow.
He violated. Listen, your eye is snatching phones. Don't get onto me.
I didn't say it was me, though. But I said someone with me did it. And I ain't baiting them up just in case anything happens.
But
saving happened like that to me, but I didn't do that, bruv.
99.9% of time it's love, and I love it. But there was one. When people come up to you, bro, I never really used to fuck with you, you know, but I rate you now.
Yeah.
That's the one that spins me every time. I'm like, am I supposed to be thankful?
It's Trips. Trips.
Gonna come on speaker.
Are you upstairs and you can't get in?
Is it past YouTube?
It's in YouTube. It's a YouTube door.
He has to wait outside for 10 minutes.
Yeah. All right, say no more, come in.
But yeah. To me, I love it. People come up to you, appreciate, show love. Yeah. It's the best thing.
Do you reckon it's because it's the right amount of people right now? Like, would you be able to handle it when it gets to the point where it's mad?
Like Michael Jackson.
He gets different fans.
Boy?
He gets different fans.
Yeah,
boys?
People faint in that. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you know what?
Do you reckon it's the numbers thing?
It all depends, man. I don't think I'll be able to cope with paparazzi outside all day, every day. But again, I don't think that's the avenue that I'm taking.
It is, bro. Because that's what that is. You know when people come up to you like, whoa, what? That is paparazzi just...
Well, listen, when UK swag. Gossip have, you know, 5 photographers on the payroll and they're all outside, you know, my house in P-Town, you get me? That's when we're good, man. But for now, like it's healthy amounts, it's good, and, like, man loves it. I wish her love. Like, just don't be weird. That's the one thing that pisses me off. Don't be weird. Jamie, do you remember when I knocked on your door?
No.
I went to Jamie's house, you know.
I don't remember that.
The day you sold Xboxes, I came to your house.
Was that you?
Mm.
You're weird, bruv. You're mad. Wait. You're mad.
I know.
No, you're mad.
Because Jamie used to live on the road behind mine.
This guy's nuts.
Knocked on the door.
You're mad, I remember you. You're a madman. Who was you with?
Just myself.
Wasn't someone standing by the gate?
No. That was your bedroom trying to get in.
Yeah. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you. They're thinking, who's this done? Bruv, you're mad.
Yeah.
No, you're mad for real. You're mad.
That's why you don't mind it.
No, he's mad, you know.
Yeah, he's grown up in a climate where this is normality.
Stop. He's nuts.
I know he's nuts. You want to see emails when he was 13 years old?
I was there. I was hungry, man. I had a meeting with Jamal Edwards last week.
He's mad.
Man showed me bare emails when I was 12.
A nigga went to someone's house he doesn't know and knocked on the door.
And
he asked me, why is he mad?
There's no rules.
I was thinking
there was rules back then when you were 14. Knock on my door when you were 14. See what happened.
Yours?
My mum will come out with a slipper.
Oh, I wish I had a camera doorbell at the time, man.
Yeah, that Ring doorbells on the thing.
Oh my God, this guy's a loops guy.
On Microsoft launch day, Jamie had bare Xboxes. And he was like, I'm selling them whatever price. Because I saw that everywhere. I was like, fuck it, man.
Man knocked my door.
I was like, this guy lives behind me. Let me just go see what they're saying.
He was laughing as he was asking. I swear, I didn't know if he was being serious. He's mad anyway. He's mad. Let's get that straight.
Wow.
Boom. Are you in a relationship?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How long for?
2 years in January.
Cool. Do you see our family? Our family?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I met them. Irish as well.
Okay. What do they think of your online presence?
They're not familiar with it. They don't watch it.
So they've got something to find out in the future. They've got stuff to find
out. Yeah, boy.
That is lit.
Wedding day. Was it? Is anyone got anything to say?
Yeah, man, videos. Not wedding day, there'll be videos.
So you plan to get married to her?
No, I'm not getting married.
Why?
Long, ma'am.
So what's the wedding
day? I know your opinion on this already.
What?
I don't know why I've heard you say this opinion.
There was a poet goes through phases where he doesn't shut up about things.
Yeah.
It was marriage.
This coming from the guy that brought up swarms, still brings up swarms, and will continue to bring up swarms. Then don't before you dance abroad. Don't worry about me. I'll still
write. But the swarms thing's a joke.
I like, man. He dashed you in the pool already.
Wait for 2020 and you can find out the truth about that because we just filmed it.
Oh yeah, okay. For real. Yeah.
Poet, do you have any siblings?
Loads.
You have?
Yeah.
You come across as the only child.
Nah, I got so many.
I swear.
Many.
Why did I giggle it? Ask anyone. I haven't even asked anyone. Yeah. But I bet you everyone thinks that you're the only child. I don't know why you got only child vibes.
Serious?
Yeah, man.
That's spoiled brat.
Not spoiled, like, I don't know. Like, super individual, like super independent. You know what I mean? Like super, you know, I can't explain it, but like,
oh, I'm the oldest, so I have to look after my brothers and sisters.
Oh, you're the oldest?
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Brexit then, quickly. Let's quickly just flex the Brexit and then out of Brexit. You get me? Any opinions on Brexit?
Yeah.
None.
Shoot.
I'm not a fan of it. We should be remaining. If I could have at the time voted, I would have voted for Remain. Yeah. But I think, unfortunately, the decision's been made, and I think the decision should be upheld, and we should leave.
Even if it was a slight majority?
Yeah. Doesn't matter.
Even if it was an ill-informed?
I don't think it was ill-informed, though.
Don't you?
And I think to say that it is ill-informed is a massive like disrespect to everyone who voted otherwise.
So then, if we was to have another referendum, it should be exactly the same. No one should have really changed their opinion.
Because the thing is, it's like a lot of people think that the reason people voted to leave the EU is because they're very dense and they don't understand. Like, people don't need to be spoon-fed information. People were told the exact same information about leaving Brexit than they were for staying in.
No, they got told, they got that bus that drove around saying they're going to give $350 million to
NHS. Yeah, but it's like, Donald Trump's been screaming around saying, lock her up, Hillary Clinton's still free. Like, there's these slogans and these things. That's how people, it's mob mentality, isn't it? When you make things slogans and you make things, it's catchy and it catches on. But a side of a red bus is not legally binding. Fair enough, you know, it's misleading. And you know, people can be upset by it, but end of the day, it's like, it's just a side of a red bus. If you actually took it as gospel, then it's like, oh. But unfortunately, you know, people can vote.
But it is part of their, part of what they were promoting. Anyway, forget that.
Yeah.
Even members of the Conservative Party, like, shifted sides, shifted seats, and went and sat with, you know what I mean? They disagreed once.
But I think it's become a thing where it's just gone on for so long, and people are just so tired of it, and people just hear it, Brexit.
Yeah.
All right, you know what? Let's just have
Election. I think the word Brexit is a dickhead thing.
It is.
But like, it's so annoying, bro.
I think, I'd love to stay in the EU. Mm. The pros, I believe, outweigh the cons massively.
I think the answer to, will we be better off out or in the EU? I think the answer last year or the year before was nobody knows.
Yeah.
That's the truth. I think nobody actually knows.
I would say
every single little thing that's going to happen and how people are going to feel, if people are going to start to spend less, you know what I mean? What's going to happen to society? No one knows. So as we're getting closer, people are starting to get a better idea of what might happen here and there, and then people are getting more informed, like, oh, that's a lie. Okay, this is, you know what I mean? Yeah. And
I think it happened too sudden.
Like, vote on it now, should we go? And you voted, we should go, let's get out.
Like, have you liked politics though?
Yeah. I've had a general, like, just a natural interest in it.
Sorry to cut you, have you always liked politics?
Never, I don't like politics. I don't like politics now at all.
I don't like politics.
That's what I
know. You sat down with Jeremy.
Yeah, I sat down with Jeremy Corbyn.
Because you used to actually don't vote. Yeah.
Yeah, I interviewed him for ID and found out he's actually a normal human being.
Yeah.
I thought, wow, this guy's a normal person. Yes, everyone registered to vote. So I wanted everyone to register to vote, and then I've tweeted out all of the manifestos.
Yeah.
Every party, everyone read all of them. If your parents are conservative, or if your parents are Green Party, read that one first if you want. And you know what I mean? Like, I'm not trying to sway you, but read it and vote for who you want to vote for. But everyone has took it as, oh,
you
interviewed Corbyn, so you are
grind for Corbyn. Yeah. Or so, you know what I mean? But I don't know, but they just lump me with everyone else.
But you can't really help that, can you?
I don't care about it either.
People that remain are the only ones that are calling for a second referendum.
I don't know.
As if it's unfair or something. But I think.
But you know what it is? No, of course not.
Of course not, because people have shifted their opinions and said, no, I voted Leave, but now I want a second referendum because I don't agree no more. I think the fact that we have political parties, Labour, Conservative, Green Party, Lib Dems, I think that's wrong. Mm. I think that's totally wrong. And then they're in the House of Commons arguing. That's wrong. That's not meant to be happening. We're meant to have local MPs, your Member of Parliament, yours, your local MP in your area that looks after your area. So David Lammy's Tottenham. He should be going around Tottenham and looking around saying, look, we need more speed bumps here by the school.
Bambo, Lambos, man.
Yeah, exactly. In your area, they should be looking after your area and going into the House of Commons as the MP of Tottenham. I think that we don't need teams. It's not football. This isn't like, yeah, Arsenal, no, Man United. Oh, come on, my God. Who's winning in the league? It's not teams. It's people that represent a local area. I would go to the meeting in my area. I'd go to the meeting and say, yeah, what's going on? Yeah, boom, boom, boom. I've got a daughter now. And yeah, there's not enough schools.
But Jamie, we used to in our area go to the, but I didn't know what it was about. My mum forced me to go to these things. Mm. And then when
I got
the information.
Still for a party though.
David Lammy was there.
You know what I'm saying? So you went to the Labour one.
Trash, fam.
Like, nobody who voted Labour, nobody who voted Conservatives, nobody who voted for any party, 100% agrees with every single one of their policies. You don't.
On the flip side of it, I can tell you the reasons why I'm not really interested in politics. I've never seen a much more confusing thing in my whole entire life.
Because of how it is, that's what I'm saying.
But most importantly, because like I don't even know where the entry point is for me. Like I felt under pressure to be a part of it at one point because I thought I need to make a contribution. I need to make a contribution to like, because I've grown up in the hood. If this means this party is going to make it less like that, then I would want young people to have a better upbringing.
Can I ask
you
something?
But hear me out. This is the only problem. I then realised I don't have enough information. Mm. I'm actually just going by what my friends say.
None of us do.
So now, until I feel I have enough information on the situation,
you never will.
Well, then I don't want to be involved.
No one does. That's the thing. No one does. No one does. No one does.
I think if you, when it comes to voting, I think you are given that information. Because what a lot of people forget is, we always talk about Corbyn and Boris Johnson, They're the two main, right? Obviously, there's Joe Swinson or whatever.
The leader of the opposition.
Opposition, yeah. Fucking HM government, all bang your doors. But really and truly, you vote locally, yeah? So when you go and put your X on the ballot box, you don't see Jeremy Corbyn's name. You would see your constituency's representative. Yeah. So in my case, Bambos Shire Lambos. And that's what the mad confusing is. So it's like, but you can go on their sites, they've got surgeries, you can go visit, they come knocking on your doors, they've got their
stuff. Look what you're asking or something. Like I'm saying to you, if you're growing up...
You're not asking anything.
No, one minute.
Alan,
for you.
Let me finish my point and then you can...
Because it's crazy, that's crazy.
Hey, politics, gasworks, magic.
Trust me. Just saying, you're saying you're not giving any information, yeah? Mm. But you can go to your local
MP. I said I don't have enough information.
No, but you can retrieve it. If you care, you can retrieve it.
But what I'm trying to say to you is, I don't know how you grew up, and it's not even me getting a dig at you, but bro...
No, but... I'm next on the mic.
From my experience, I want to hand the mic. Yeah. Boom, 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 beats running. Yeah. I'm just saying, when I was growing up, the pressures that my mum and all of that went through, we didn't ever speak about that. That was never a concern or anything. So, like, where it was never the situation, I've naturally grown up and not really been a part of it. Yeah. Then, as I've got older, thought to myself, do you know what? There's some people around me a little bit younger that actually show me the significance of that. And I never, like, bypass what anyone says. So I thought, let me try and take it on board. But then it was, like, basically saying, I want to learn Japanese within a year. I was like, I can't learn this. This is actually far too much information. And, unfortunately, for me, where I am right now, I got to sort this shit out. And then I have to come back to that later.
Okay. I know you're next on the mic, but...
Yeah, no, what? No, no.
No, no.
Hey, don't touch the mic. Boom. This is what I want to say. Alhan, you're wrong because you're saying you can retrieve the information. If that was the case and you could really retrieve the information, we would all have the same information and we'll all vote for the same people. But we don't because we are ill-informed. Different parties will say different things. Oh, we'll spend this much on that. We'll spend that much on that. But will you do it? Then another party will say, look at the history of spending. They're saying they're going to do it. But before, when Tony Blair was in power, he did it. Like, it's just basically... football teams. So it's not. It shouldn't be teams like that. So, wait. So, Jackham. So to back poet, he's ill. He's not informed enough, and he never will be. And neither is anyone else. Everyone you see in suits on TV saying, "Oh yes," and whatever, bruv. You don't know nothing either, bruv. You don't know nothing either because you're just trying to get money to put into your little second property or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, and all of our local MPs go to the House of Commons and speak on behalf of their local constituency and what we actually need. And then Poet will feel like, you know what? Speaking for me, they're actually saying what I actually believe. And you will say, you know what? Bambo's actually speaking for me.
Yes.
There's a mic.
Thank you. I don't, okay. I'll just say this, yeah. The vinyl skipping, man.
Come on, man.
I'll say this, yeah. Poet's saying that for him, he won't vote because he hasn't got the information. Yeah. My thing is this. If you want to go and retrieve that information, yeah, you can go out there, do your research and find what MPs that are on your ballot list, your polling sheet, whatever, are going to promise you. Whether you trust them, that's a completely separate point, yeah? But I can't be wrong because if when there's an election, this is the system that we've got at the moment. So Poet is saying that he's ill-informed and whatnot, yeah?
I haven't said that.
No. So no,
You're saying you haven't got the information, yeah? Yeah. You're saying you haven't got the information. But you can go and do the research if you care and find out. Again, whether you think they're really going to do that, this mic's heavy, boy. You got a wireless one. Whether you think that is going to, whether you think they're actually going to go and do that in part, that's completely separate. And I agree with you. I think the whole party, it just becomes teams and really and truly it's like, wait, are you not even fighting for me? You just want to be in, like, where am I in all this?
So
you
just want to be in power. This is what I'm trying to
say. But I'm just saying,
confusing, bro.
Okay, but 1 minute. I think as adults, yeah, we have a responsibility for the future of our kids and whatnot, whatever, one day when I have kids and whatnot. It is very confusing, but it's the system that we've got now. Yeah. Until there's going to be a revolution and people are going to go out there and fight on street corners and everything's going to change. Like Vuj said, when 10 million people spoil the ballot, you get me? When that revolution comes, that's right. But right now, the system that we've got is this.
This is all I'm going to
say. But that information is there.
I haven't got to close this up, man.
Let me just say my last point. All I'm saying is this, Alhan. See, everything you're saying, in actual reality, yeah, it can happen, but we just have to be realistic. I said to you, in my habits in my day and my responsibilities and what I have to do, for me to have another added responsibility of learning something which is extremely important, I can't just read a couple of things and say, 1 second, and make it seem that I now have enough information to make a decision based upon something that's going to affect everyone in this room. I don't even want that much responsibility. That's like far too... Hear me out.
Let him finish. I need to speak after you. Go on.
I'm saying that's a lot of responsibility. So I feel like if you, who's been grown up in this situation... In a sense of you've always been interested in politics, yeah? Cool, so I've not been interested in it. Yeah. So if you are gonna make a decision based upon that, it's better that people that are gonna make good decisions with more information make them decisions rather than people jumping on Twitter, encouraging everyone to vote. Look at the people at the forefront of situations about racism. You've got loads of brands doing campaigns to make money off racism.
And doing it wrong.
Yeah. But that's these are
the mental health things.
So when I come forward and say, I don't wanna be a part of it, it's just almost like, no, I'm saying that based upon the fact that, do you know what? We need people that are more informed in situations that affect people's lives to be making decisions on it. This is mad.
What he said, I hear in him, and I'm not taking anything away from that. Go.
Okay, this is what I'm saying, yeah? It's like you're talking about learning everything and a responsibility.
Learning enough to make a decision.
Okay, yeah.
That's gonna change life.
But you're you compared it to like learning Japanese in a whatever.
Never said that.
He said it's like
that. I looked at it when I saw all the information. Like learning Japanese in a year. And I'm not saying for everyone because there's someone in that room that could. I'm saying for me, with my responsibilities in my life,
listen,
that's too much.
I hear you.
Does that make sense?
It makes 100% sense. Okay. I want to hear what he's going to say.
But this is the thing. You don't actually have a responsibility. You are not responsible for any of that. That's why you have a local MP that's part of your constituency. It's up to them to take on that responsibility.
I don't trust David Lammy.
Okay, well, this is what I'm saying. And that goes back to
trust. I've got David Lammy, though. You're hitting them too hard, man.
I know I've done youth work for 10 years, and I know all of the things that he used to come down to my youth centre and promise the young people, and they didn't deliver. I took money out of my own pocket to deliver it.
I used to go to that youth club.
You wasn't even born.
No, he was.
What's going on?
I don't know, I worked for them in 2000.
Exposure, exposure with the magazine. With the
The
E in like a shadow.
Yeah.
Not everyday middle class.
All I'm going to say is, I agree with what he's saying as well. Like, you have to be born and live the life of not knowing what's going on and not even caring because you don't even know if you're
going to... I still don't know if you're going to get kicked out in two weeks.
So you can't... Like, voting for someone is not even important because you might never be in the country.
But
like,
how do you get kicked out in 3 weeks' time
you,
and I'm trying
you
to...
You vote for someone and then you get deported or whatever.
I've got to focus on something else.
So let me say this.
My dad's still ain't got his passport.
Okay, stop. Hey.
Yo!
Hey, jacket. Jack! Hey, Gaslers, make some noise! All right, boom. I'm just going to end it with saying, the reason why I think we shouldn't even have parties is because when you vote for someone that I disagree with, that then creates tension in communities where, you're a Tory. Oh, yeah, Jamie's only Tory now because he made his money and he wants to save his money.
Okay.
Offshore account, all this stuff. Yeah, you know what I mean? If you just actually, in your small community, your local area, your constituency of I don't know how many people are in one, but you all vote in that area, That's it, on what you want. Your MP goes and speaks about it in the House of Commons, and if it gets passed, it gets passed. If it doesn't, it doesn't.
If it were down to me, yeah, you go, do the ballot box, you don't tell no one. You can tell your family, you might all vote for the same thing, but it's not a conversation. It isn't a mob mentality. You fucking Tory.
If it was that way, then cool. It's not that way.
But it's not, yeah.
You know, it's not. On TV afterwards, everything.
But it's up to you to just not make it about that.
But it's not even, oh no, sorry. It's from the top down, bro.
Us civilians
can't be like, we're going to be like, when the people we're voting for are in court, in House of Commons saying, oh, if I was you, I wouldn't wear that suit. Look at that tie. Yeah. Oh, he's only going to put it like, they're just being idiots,
bro. This is exactly why Trump won. Because these are the tactics that people use. It's mob mentality. It's exactly like a football game. You go to House of Commons.
And that's why he ain't part of it, because it's so stupid. He ain't got information and he feels alienated.
But I think Poet is 47?
Hey, lie, man.
I think you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't vote. That's all I'm saying.
Alhan, did you go to private school or did you go boarding school?
I went to a private boarding school.
It was an interracial relationship in the school.
What's the reason for that question?
Because I wanted to know, what music did you listen to when you was at school?
Okay, nothing but Graham and my boy Hamza. We went to the same school. He can tell you. In boarding, there used to be corridors.
It was exciting.
And I had a Boy Better Know flag pinned up. I think it was
flag.
From, yeah.
From where?
The Culture Clash one.
Okay. So you were in the school when we had Culture Clash?
Yeah.
That's like, it feels like the other day.
Are you joking? There's been about two Culture Clashes after we've done one.
No, I know, but I said it feels like the other day. For me, because I'm a little older, he was actually in school.
Culture Clash was the other day still. Like, I mean, we haven't made 10 albums since, sorry.
Okay,
But yeah, so I used to have that pinned up here. Oh, I can't remember how young I was, but the first thing I ever saw music video wise was my boy, his brother came in and he showed us all over the house. I was like, what is this?
Wow, and do you know how clean that was? That was trust me.
But anyway,
we had a mad introduction.
So I had the flags everywhere, whatnot. These are the same times I was knocking on your door anyway. And then one day I came here.
It's crazy,
man. One day I went back into my corridor and my flag was just not there, and all the pictures, there was Skepta pictures, everything. And I was like, sir, like, where's all my stuff? That was in my, like, it was, I was like, oh yeah, it's gone. I was like, what? And that's when I realized, I was like, nah, these are just racist, fam. In class, yeah, there was a boy called Callum Innit, he looked like Stewie Griffin, man. I said, what, have you heard Devlin? Like, I only listen to black music. I was like, nah.
What, in your school?
Yeah. So that's why then, and I completely understand the stigma with private school and whatnot, but yeah.
You drive now. Have you had any encounters with the police yet?
I got pulled over. Undercover police, yeah? So listen to this. I was in Soho, I was waiting for my other boy, and I'm driving to Knightsbridge now. Oxford Street, I'm like, I'm bored, man. Red light, it takes time. Jumped out, stripped off, I just went down to my boxes.
Why, stop, what's going on?
There's no rules, is there a manual?
What, to jumping out your gear?
Was it car manual or mic?
Manual.
There was a manual then.
You win.
Hey.
That was good, that was,
that was good. That was good, that was good.
It was just banter, man, because the boys were behind us as well. I was like, fuck it, let me strip. And then, jump back in. I'm driving. I'm swerving onto the other side.
Have you got your clothes on? Like,
huh? Yeah. Okay. I've redressed. I'm mounting pavements. I'm just doing me, man. I just see blue lights behind me. I'm like, nah, it can't be.
Georgia Smith.
I'm dead.
Mad team.
So then they pull me over. I've got limo tints, remember?
I know you have got limo tints.
So I've got my limo tints now, and I've just pressed both buttons and the windows have come down. Oh, key out the ignition, all of this. And obviously, I've watched bare videos of police pulling over, man better know, all these things,
sick.
But it's like, no, all these people, I know my rights. I was like, blood, I'm actually starving. I'm on my way to eat. I can do the rude boy, I know my rights, I'm staying in the car. I'm not obliged to get out of the vehicle, this and that. But I was like, nah, I'm actually, let me. And they were cool guys. He starts talking to me about Outlook Festival. I was like, what?
Mad.
I was like, where's that come from? And he goes, Corrupt FM. I was like, nah, man, not to be big-headed, but I was like, this guy knows who I am and he's pulled me over for no reason, fam. He's like, yeah, the reason we pulled you over, there's been robberies. I was like, blood, you think I'll do a robbery in a hatchback? I get a van at least, man.
In central London as well?
In central, yeah. And I was like, nah, it's a wrap, the tints have to come off because my number plate's illegally spaced. I don't know why I'm snitching on myself.
Illegally spaced,
yeah.
Yeah, you need to do another episode of this and just cut everything out. Well, do that, eh?
Nah, it's cool, man. And then he goes, yeah, you can go. I've done his PNC check, everything. I'm like, calm. I thought I was going to get in trouble, man.
No, you're lucky.
Trust me.
Love it. This is a long question. See, you're making me ask you these questions, bruv.
I'll answer quickly.
You're very outspoken. You say what's on your mind with no filter. And you felt the burn this can cause as well, online and whatever. Where do you think we are going with PC culture?
This is what it is for me, yeah. And this is how I've decided to approach the situation off the back of the Copper 90 situation.
I know who I'm speaking to now. I'm very comfortable with who I'm speaking to. And as long as I don't try and offend them, and I don't offend them, I can't think about the world. It's way too much. So I think about my community and doing what's in the best interest of my community. So I will say, however I feel, as long as I don't disrespect anybody.
That you know you're
going to be. Yeah, yeah, and not just in my community, just in general. Yeah. But if I say something that is taken out of context by somebody else who has limited information on me, that is no longer my problem, because you've taken it upon yourself to see one tweet or one thing and then built this whole world around me without even knowing me. That means that you was never going to like me anyway. So why do I even care what you think? And I will say a lot of the people that come and support me and Vuj's channel off the back of the incident that happened definitely woke me up to that, because I was so like, I was down in the dumps, fam. Yeah. And then when you realise, wait a minute, they're like, nah, Paul, we know what type of person you are. That's not a, you know, an example of your character. You're like, rah, so if Twitter didn't exist, no one would even say this, what they're saying right now. So half the people saying this, you're actually the cunts. And then when Alhan exposed half of them, their things that they were saying were either the same level or 20 times worse. And it's like, do you know what? Dance a yard before you dance abroad. Done.
But I want to spin this question back on you, yeah? Because if you look at the history, for you boy better know, like obviously there's been mad things.
Yeah.
But there's a song that you lot have got, which is Mandem in Disguise, Transvestites.
Yeah.
Back then, yeah.
Transvestites now is actually a term.
Exactly.
That you shouldn't use, I'm sure. Yeah. I think it's transgender now.
Transgender,
transvestites
yeah.
might be an offensive term now.
Exactly.
But
and
it
I
wasn't.
Think that's the
connotation.
So I'd like to ask you this, yeah. How has it affected you and PC culture? Because I don't think you could, if you made that song today and brought it out, I think
it might be, oh my God, well, yeah. My only discrepancy with that song is the fact that I said, Robin Hood can fly, but not these men in tights. But it's not Robin Hood can fly, it's Peter Pan. But I don't even know, I don't know, fam, I swear. That's my But other than that, even back then, I kind of knew that I don't want to offend no one. Because I'm a musician. My bar's not offensive at all. It shouldn't be.
No, it's not. But
it shouldn't
be.
Out of context, it can be. But my bars, I said, I've got no problems with your sexuality, but why are you trying to trick me? Because we're talking about a specific situation. Mm-hmm. We're talking about going to Amsterdam as teenagers.
Happened to your bedroom.
Going to Amsterdam as teenagers.
Oh my God. I'm
walking down a strip where you think it's women in the windows.
Yeah. And it's green light.
But they're men.
Blue light. Yeah.
But you don't know.
But
and they come out into the street, take Maximum's hat. Hey, come in here. Take your hat into the window. You're walking there. You didn't want to go into the windows.
Yeah.
But now they've got your hat and you're standing there thinking shit. Like, there's no political.
I hear that. Yeah, that's something
exactly.
That
but
you
back
guys
then,
know.
Back then, we were making music for our audience
exactly.
on pirate radio, raves. You man, we just come back from Amsterdam. Look what happened. It's mad. We're talking about real stories.
Yeah.
So we're saying they're Mandem in disguise.
Yeah.
Because that's what it was to us. You know what I'm saying? Whereas now, yes, I know I'm talking to a much bigger audience, mm-hmm. and I'd be like, I'd have to explain more before I say what I'm gonna say.
Would you?
Yeah, but you don't have to
song,
explain. I think you just got to find a unique way.
I'll put my verse down on the song 100%. My verse is clear.
So I would just say this: the joke about something isn't always as bad as that thing.
Yeah.
Fuck PC culture. Bye. Yeah. Fuck PCs overall.
I'm Mac. You're just a PC.
Yeah.
Hey, thank you for having me, man. I'll be back on someday.
Yeah.
Well, I enjoyed this, man.
Thank you, bro.
This was like a podcast.
I appreciate it so much.
By the way, the books are, all the photographs are taken by Jordan Curtis Hughes. They're from the video shoots. That's the CD. If you haven't got a CD player,
did I make sense then, by the way?
Yeah, 100% you did. I got you, 100%. If I don't get you, I'll tell you. But yeah,
you're
mad.
Yeah. These are the hoodies. You can buy them. The link's in the description. That's my plug.
Which camera?
Don't do that.
It's bad luck, but.
I saw Skepta do it on the show. All right, cool. Send them on. 35 bags.
Umbrella. Hey, which camera are you talking to?
All of them, man.
I thought something else.
Died.
Okay, yeah, man. Respect. Love, man. Thank you,
Jamie.
Man.
Thank you very much.
30 seconds.
Love.